we have two major crises, globally speaking. We have climate change, which is getting more and more extreme. And at the same time, we have massive biodiversity loss at all levels. And very recent paper just came out in Nature showing that we thought that it was, you know, particularly the amphibians or certain animal species that were threatened, but actually the plant species are, if not more threatened than the animals. And we tend to have this plant bias that we don't tend to see the plants. And so here we're really looking at what's happening with the plants and how those changes in the plant community affect the animal diversity, especially the pollinators. So if we don't do something to increase biodiversity again, we're seriously in trouble with many different functions and services that these systems provide for us. Well, we're here in this traditional orchard in Wendisch Evern, and it's part of the sustainability minor. And the course is called Ecological Restoration for Sustainability.
A seminar that runs for 4 semesters, which means 5 modules. And the students work together all the way in these 5 modules. And this is very special because the students didn't know each other because they come from different majors, different faculties, and then they start to work in a research project in this traditional orchard.
Now we are over time removing the hay, so the grassland biomass, with the students and watching the biodiversity hopefully increase. So we increase the biodiversity because we add apple trees, but we also following how the grassland species increase over time. Plus, this is a very special project because we are working with the students and it's place-based. We have this orchard where we work with the local Streuobstwiesenverein directly, and we use it for the teaching, but it's also a research project. So over time we can watch with different groups of students. They work together the whole time in those 4 semesters, and it becomes more and more interactive, more and more transdisciplinary, where they are basically doing project management as well as research and learning.
Der ausschlaggebende Punkt für mich ist, dass man hier tatsächlich erlebt, wie Forschung geht. Also man geht raus ins Feld, wortwörtlich, und sieht, was es alles braucht, um eben Research zu betreiben. Validität zum Beispiel oder Reproduzierbarkeit, das sind wichtige Sachen. Aber so richtig vorstellen kann man sich das dann immer noch nicht, finde ich. Und hier geht man ins Feld und muss ein Protokoll schreiben und sieht dann, okay, wir haben uns das Protokoll so und so vorgestellt. Das funktioniert überhaupt nicht so, wie wir es gerade haben. Wir brauchen noch die Kategorie und das muss alles nochmal verändert werden. Und man stößt auf Probleme, die man sich vorher gar nicht vorstellen konnte. Und das ist, glaube ich, auch das Besondere, dass man eben in der Praxis lernt, wie die Sachen eigentlich funktionieren.
The students really get a connection to nature that I feel they didn't necessarily have before. And they also get a connection to working outdoors and working, doing fieldwork in ecology or in social ecological systems.
Macht auf jeden Fall Spaß. Es war auch teilweise immer so das Highlight der Woche dann.
Ich würde es auf jeden Fall auch nochmal machen, weil es mich wirklich sehr bereichert. Es sorgt für viel Freude in meinem Uni-Alltag. Das ist ganz schön.
It's special because it's an innovative project. So the students, guided by the instructors, decide what they want to research. It's always around biodiversity loss and the idea of restore the traditional orchard and increase biodiversity. But somehow they decide what they want to focus.
Das ist nicht so dieser Top-Down-Unterricht, wo man einfach nur drinnen sitzt und sich berieseln lässt. Also man muss sich auch selbst einbringen und das macht aber auch Spaß eben. Man wird gehört und gefragt auch. Also Bertha und Vicky sind da auch immer offen für Ideen. Ich bin super zufrieden, dass ich das Seminar belegt habe. Also ich habe das jetzt schon abgeschlossen und mir hat das auch so gut gefallen, dass ich das gerne auch weitergeben wollte. Deswegen bin ich auch Tutorin jetzt von der nächsten Kohorte.
It's very challenging to set this project because the students should know how to do research, should learn also how to do research in teams. So also it's very special because we have a coach who guides them from the 3rd semester to the end. And this person, Catherine, guides them in terms of team building, conflict management, time management, project management. How interact, how to solve conflicts in the teams, how to organize themselves.
Wir bekommen ganz viel Input dazu, was man tun kann, wenn man Probleme hat im Team, wie man eigentlich seine Rolle im Team findet. Das führt auf jeden Fall dazu, dass man sich auf einer anderen Ebene versteht als nur eine einfache Gruppenarbeit.
If you look around the surrounding landscape, it's very intensively managed. There are monoculture crops and they're sprayed with pesticides and fertilizers, and In here we're not spraying anything, so to us it's like a little island of biodiversity where the insects, especially the pollinators, can come and get what they need. They get the nectar and the pollen. It's not maybe big enough, but since we hope it's a model project, we hope to inspire other people to do similar things to restore traditional orchards. But we also have an extra component which is very innovative. We have an experiment under the apple trees where we have sown different combinations of grassland flowering species. So we are not just increasing the biodiversity of the site with the Streuobstwiesenverein, so it's a transdisciplinary project. We are at the same time tracking how an additional biodiversity treatment is maybe attracting even more pollinators. So we're trying to see, can we restore and how long does it take? But also, how can we even jumpstart the biodiversity by doing extra experiments and understand for possible future projects?
Wenn man der Umwelt einfach mehr bewusst ist, dann kann man das auch, dann kann man nicht darüber wegschauen. Also deswegen fängt man halt auch an, mehr darüber nachzudenken, über sich selbst, über den Konsum. Und ja, deswegen werde ich da auf jeden Fall in die Richtung weitermachen.